also, we've got a massive problem with the most dangerous man in Britain, Crazy Ed Miliband. I mean, my God, what he's announced today. This is this bizarre company, GB Energy, that he says will make a profit in 5 years' time. That is, Ed, when we can work out what the hell it is. But basically, Starmer and him, he is our net zero secretary, have announced today a £60 billion investment in green energy, which is a strange kind of deal with the king, because it turns out that the Crown estates own loads of the seabeds around
Britain.
Yes,
that's right.
So they're going to put these massive loads and loads and loads of these massive windmills into the sea, which will hand the king a bumper paycheck. So as they say with these issues, Isabel, always follow the money. And Kingy, Mr. Charles, or whatever you want to be called, if you're a proper environmentalist, don't take the money for this. How about that?
Yeah, I mean, it's weird how they don't like... One of the first things that the new Labour government has done is said, you know, we don't want any more drilling, we're going to stop all these projects in the sea up in the, in the North Sea. And yet they want to plonk these things into the ocean, which no doubt causes huge environmental destruction in the installation process. And these things look hideous. You know, they really do. I just saw them a week or so ago off Skegness, you know, and basically it just turns the sea into an industrial site.
Yeah, indeed. And they say that this is going to, once they get to these vast numbers of windmills, what's it Alex Phillips called?
Wimwoms.
Is that like her personal word for them that we're all supposed to understand?
Although it does make them sound almost a little bit cute. Yeah, a wimwom.
Well, I prefer
they're not cute.
I prefer
giant bird blenders.
Bird blenders, yeah. Yeah. Lots of seagulls are going to meet their maker thanks to this new project. But they're saying it will, all of these windmills will deliver up to, and I never know what the hell this means, 30 gigawatts. What does that mean? Of wind power, enough to supply nearly 20 million homes, except when it's not windy.
Yeah. Which, in fairness, is not that often in this country, but you know.
So the Crown Estate made a record £1.1 billion profit this year, last year, and they take, I think it's 12% of all the profits from the Crown Estate. To be fair, the state takes the rest. But this new deal will put potentially billions into the pocket.
What's the time frame for it?
Well, they're keeping that vague, I think.
Yeah, I'm sure they are. 60 billion, well, that's what? What's that, about half the cost of HS2? Mm. I mean, maybe they could scrap HS2 and put a few wimwoms up where the line was supposed to go and leave our seas alone.
Yeah, I mean, that is another aspect to this. I mean, you know, aesthetics, I suppose, have to take second place to energy and all that. But they are hideous, these things, and they're very dangerous to birds. I suppose they're better off the coast. But when they put them all across the land, you go to the West Country now, they've turned the West Country, the once beautiful West Country, into War of the Worlds.
No, I was shocked seeing these. I think we talked about this yesterday in Cornwall. Mm. Really, really ugly. Mm. Also, there are a lot of them in the north and west coast of Scotland. And again, they look... Like, sometimes I think they can look quite majestic in a small and limited fashion, but when they're tearing across the countryside, they really are an absolute eyesore.
Indeed. So this is the thing. First of all, they're going to put all these windmills in. Right, first, who makes the windmills?
Yeah.
China.
Yeah,
what do they make the windmills with? Coal fuel power. It's just ridiculous.
Yeah. It's just allowing us to virtue signal at the same time as just basically offsetting our energy use to other countries. Yeah. I mean, it's exactly the same with industrial farming, something I know that you don't like, factory farming, you know, put all these animals in tightly packed into sheds, meaning that you have to transport their food to them. Animals are supposed to be on fields, people, cows on grass, not in dark sheds. All we're doing is actually making someone else put aside their land to grow the crops that you then need to transport at vast environmental cost to the animals in the sheds. It's the same thing.
And when the wind is blowing we've got plenty of power, of course you store the energy that these windmills supply. And what kind of storage facilities do we have? Oh, I know, none whatsoever. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, well, maybe. Maybe it'll be like all these things and it just won't actually come to fruition.
If Ed's in charge, almost certainly won't. By the end of it,
we'll probably have half a dozen win-woms, as Alex would say, and and an awful lot of public money will have been wasted not achieving the win-woms.
Do you think Ed Miliband, a lifelong parliamentary twonk, would ever get a job anywhere else except Westminster? That well-known refuge from the real world, Westminster?
Well, his brother's quite successful. Do you remember the brother is earning a little bit shy of £1 million?
Yeah,
running a refugee charity or something, a humanitarian thing.
Yeah, it's called International Rescue, which for me is Thunderbirds, isn't it?
Over in New York, nice lifestyle. I'll never forget how those two fell out. It was one of the most astonishing political stories that I've ever covered. One stabbing the other in the back, and that was the end of that relationship.
Indeed. But I speculated on Twitter this morning that he probably could get a job elsewhere at the Looney Tunes film studios as one of the characters.
You know what? I think you underestimate just how many jobs there are going in the whole eco-zealotry industry. Yeah. I mean, actually, I think he'd be in hot demand. I think he will probably end up being one of the highest ex-cabinet minister earners, because there's a ton of money to be made on this circuit.
So if there are any eco companies out there, cashing in all this, and you want to waste a lot of the massive profits you're unreasonably making, hire Ed Miliband. That's a good way to set fire to a mountain of cash, I'll tell you. But seriously, he has no real-world experience. His political career has been one long chain of catastrophes. He's the one who's responsible for Jeremy Corbyn with his ridiculous let everyone join the party and vote. He was hopeless against Cameron in that election. Remember the Ed Stone?
Oh, yeah, the Ed Stone.
I'm probably being rather too disrespectful of...
By the way, he's actually quite nice.
I don't care. He's an absolute... absolute idiot.
Bacon sandwich, do you remember that?
He's a dangerous idiot. He really, really is. And I don't know why, we talked about this the other day. Why do you think Keir Starmer is in such thrall to this rather sort of naive little eco-nut?
Well, there is a small matter of experience. I mean, Ed is one of the few that's actually held some government jobs in the past, so maybe there's a bit of that. Is he old enough to be an elder statesman? Not really. I don't know.
He's not a statesman, I'll tell you this. Listen, when we come back, we're going to talk about something I thought might interest you. It certainly interests me. And it's about what you said earlier, this kind of fact that our unfolding political nightmare is energising people.
And that's actually quite exciting in a way.
It is. So it turns out that more under-30s voted for reform in the election than voted Tory.